We're talking with Jerry Golke as an add-on to our weekend market edition here. And Jerry, we're looking at the dollar index and the crude oil market. They're kind of going separate directions here.
Yeah, the dollar, in theory, that makes our crude oil cheaper because it's most of it's priced in dollars. And when that goes up, the crude oil has a tendency to go down. But we've seen a little change in things. Technically, we had our first sell signal in the dollar index. I don't know if I've got guts enough to sell it outright. But what it does tell me is that those products that are sensitive to the dollar, soybeans, corn, and crude oil, might have an impetus now to go back up again. And then I look at crude oil and I say, my gosh, it's dropped from near $88 down to $65 in a matter of a month, probably. This is pretty significant in that we're now testing the October lows. And today was the last trading day for the crude oil in June, which is the lead contract I look at. That's the demand side. And crude oil in June closed $4 off the lows. It got down to $64, closed at $68. Told me that somebody didn't want to deliver $64 crude because the next month to come on is July, and it has a carry, kind of like corn does from May to July and July to September and so forth. And it'll come on at $70 on Monday. So if you look at a continuation chart, you look at $64 and say, wow, we're $6 above it. That was kind of interesting in that we may take July crude oil back down a little bit, but it tells me it's in an area where we need to take a look at getting our cash quotes from our jobbers and look at locking in some stuff for next fall. I like to do it because I plug it into my cash flow and I look at this and say, chart's fine. Everything looks good. We drop down. We could drop down to $56, but I don't think you're going to drop $20 a barrel anymore. So the big gain from all this has already been in place. Now, if the wholesale price will narrow up, then that's fine. But here's a product. It's kind of like somebody offering me for 10 minutes the price of hemp fertilizer being half what it was just 3-4 months ago. I'd probably jump on it. I lock in that input cost for my cash flow, and I say I don't have to worry about crude oil anymore for my fall harvest needs. And I don't care what Jerry Golke says about crude oil. I've locked one in, and I'm done. So.
Now, obviously, this is an ag commodity report that we're doing here, but what's all this mean to ethanol and the corn markets?
Well, it's interesting. The corn market has been going kind of opposite the crude oil. If you notice, for not years, but a couple of years, people were looking at soybeans being priced against diesel fuel, soybean oil, and corn is now an energy product. Well, crude oil has dropped like a rock, and you would suspect that that would apply to corn prices, but it hasn't. And I think the last article I wrote for Top Producer talked about is there going to be a disconnect between corn and crude oil, because it seems to me about a 6-month lag. When crude oil took off, corn took a little while before it finally caught up, and you had to prove that crude oil stayed up there, and then here come the price of corn. It seems like that's been lost in this attack on regulations and so forth, and there's been a lot of traders who've been fearful of what's going on, looking for a scapegoat for the price of crude oil, and have elected to move some of their accounts to overseas where there isn't the regulation. And I think some of this crude oil may have been, all right, I've been long crude oil, I'm selling my crude, I'm going to repurchase it again in Amsterdam or in London somewhere. And we've been warned and told that you mess with the regulation, make it difficult for money to trade, and we'll just take our marbles and trade somewhere else. So I think before we really put any kind of a correlation with it, we need to see whether crude oil is going to stay down here for the summer months, and then also to find out if our corn crop is going to be as good as we thought. Because if it isn't, are we going to lose 400 million bushel usage in ethanol? I doubt it. We're exporting it now. We're a net exporter. And China buys DDGs. They like them. So the DDGs is helping. So I think that ethanol thing is coming of age to where it can lose a little bit in the profitability from ethanol, gain it back in DDGs. And also, you know, you got China buying some of the excess. So a good time to be in agriculture. That's not much that other industries can say. I kind of view agriculture now as an oasis in a sea of uncertainty, and we need to appreciate that fact more than we do, probably.
All right, and Jerry, you've got a whole bunch of charts here that people can get a hold of.